You've probably heard about entanglement. Entanglement is quite important in quantum cryptography. Entanglement is also an essential ingredient in quantum computation, in fact, in all of quantum information. It is fair to say that entanglement is one of the defining features in what makes quantum different from the classical world. We will see that we can understand the security of quantum key distribution solely by thinking about entanglement, about some special property of the state psi AB shared between Alice A and Bob B. Entanglement is real. We made quantum entanglement in the first loophole-free Bell test in Delft between Alice and Bob. On our campus, Alice and Bob were roughly 1.3 kilometers apart. Alice is here, where all our QTech offices are, and Bob is a bit further down the campus, on the site of the nuclear reactor. So given that we can make entanglement, you might be wondering what entanglement really is. Of course, we are not going to go into all of the rather beautiful philosophical aspects that arise from the concept of entanglement. This would need a whole lecture series by itself. Instead, we will have a look at how we can work with entanglement to design secure quantum protocols. To do this, it is useful to know what it means mathematically for a quantum state to be entangled. But before I give you a definition, let's start with an example of two qubits, A and B. There is a state that you've already seen, the EPR pair, which looks like this. This state is entangled between qubit A and qubit B. The fact that the state is entangled will be quite useful for quantum key distribution. We will call this state maximally entangled because it has quite special properties. For example, you've already calculated that if Alice measures her qubit A in the standard basis, and Bob measures his qubit B also in the standard basis, then they will always get the same outcome. In fact, I encourage you to calculate that if Alice measures her qubit in the Hadamard basis, and Bob also measures in the Hadamard basis, they will also get the same outcome. You can think that the EPR pair, or a maximally entangled state of two qubits, is the most maximally correlated state that we could think of. For every measurement that Alice makes on A, if Bob makes the same measurement on B, they will get the same outcome. Entanglement also has another property that we will investigate in detail. Namely, entanglement is monogamous. If Alice and Bob are maximally entangled, then it is not possible for anything else in the universe to have any share of this entanglement. Mathematically, this means that if Alice and Bob are maximally entangled, then the state rho AB and the rest of the universe, which I will call E, is maximally entangled on AB and uncorrelated with whatever state the rest of the universe has. Let's now write down mathematically what it means for a state to be entangled. I will start to define what it means to be entangled for pure states. If we talk about entanglement, it is always important to specify which system we are entangled across. Here, we will say we are entangled between A and B. A might be one or more qubits and B might be one or more qubits. Let's say that the joint state of A and B together is psi AB. If I can write the state psi AB as a tensor product of some state on A, tensor some state on B, then we will call the state separable. If, on the other hand, the state cannot be written as a tensor product between some state on A and some state on B, meaning the state is not separable, then we will call the state entangled. So a state can be either entangled or separable. Let's have a look at two examples. You've already seen the first one, it is the EPR pair, which is an entangled state. Now let's have a look at the state where the second qubit is always in the one state. At first glance, this state may look just like the EPR pair. But as you can see, we can write it as the tensor product of some state on A. In fact, this is the plus state on A, tensor the one state on B. This state is therefore separable. Now you may be asking, when is a mixed state, a density matrix, entangled? We have seen how entanglement works for pure state. So if I write the pure state as a density matrix, then we would expect that the state is entangled if psi cannot be written as a tensor product of two matrices. Indeed, this idea generalizes. Let me again first write down separable states. We say that the density matrix rho AB is separable if there exists some probability distribution Pj, for some symbols j, and some corresponding states rho aj and rho bj, such that I can write rho ab as a mixture of separable states. If rho ab is not separable, then we will call it entangled. Let's have a look at some examples of separable or entangled density matrices. The first example is this one. Here we can immediately identify what this probability distribution is. Say this is P0 and this is P1. And what the corresponding density matrices are. This would be rho 0a, and this would be rho 0b. Similarly, this would be rho 1a and rho 1b. So we can write the state as a mixture, mixing here half-half, over tensor products of states, meaning the state is a separable state. Let's imagine now that the state of A and B is in a CQ state, a classical quantum state. As you can see, all classical quantum states satisfy the condition of being separable. They are a mixture of a tensor product of density matrices. They are separable. Let's have a look at the EPR pair. We know that this state is entangled, but here I give you the state as a density matrix. Don't worry if you think that it is difficult to see that the state is entangled just by looking at this density matrix. It turns out that it is even computationally hard to determine whether a given density matrix is entangled or separable. You can find some pointers to the literature about testing whether a state is entangled or separable in the lecture notes.